This guide is meant for experienced players. If you need step-by-step instructions on where to start the quest, how to get to certain locations, or other basic things of that nature, this guide is not for you. Quest in aid of Myreque. You are required to have 25 crafting, 15 mining, 7 magic, and need to have completed in search of the Myreque, however it's pronounced, and nature spirit. And then the items that you need are a silver sickle, spade, 5 buckets, pickaxe, hammer, 11 planks, 44 nails, 1 swamp paste, 10 raw mackerel or 10 snail, it'll be random whichever one's required in the quest, 10 bronze axes, 4 tinder boxes, 2 steel bars, coal, soft clay, rope, silver bar, meath bar, sapphire, water rune, cosmic rune, and that is all the required items. Then I'd recommend bringing or having some Morton teleports, stamina potions, steel med, steel chain body, silver sickle, steel plate legs, at least 15 salmon, and then other potions and food and weapons for combat. So to start the In Aid of Myreque quest, you start it here. You talk to Valif Hertz. Your option is 131. You want to head to Morton. Once over here, talk to Florin. After that, use a salmon on the box to open chest. Should be a little cutscene. Then you want to talk to Razvan once you go inside the gate. Should be over here, this general area. There he is inside here. Two options, 4. Climb over the broken wall. Use your pickaxe on the rubble. Open trap door, go down. Now you want to clear all the rubble in this room, which is usually takes a little while, but I'm not sure if mining level affects it or not. But just mine the rubble until you stop mining, then use your spade on the remaining rubble. You do that for every single spot. Thank you. there is a plaster fragment. You should get that sometime while you're mining. And then there's also a scroll that you'll get. Those are the two items that you want to get. If you don't get those two items, then I think you can go search a rubble pile behind this building that I'm in. So if I don't get the scroll, I'll go and show you that. Otherwise, you should be able to find it pretty easily. There's the scroll. So I have the two items that I need. This is my last one. Should we get some dialogue if it is my last one? Yep, there we go. Now you want to head back up. Drop the nails and whatever stuff. You don't need it, or you can keep it, but you won't need it for the quest. So make sure you keep your iron nails. Speak to Razvan. Chat options 3. And make sure you read these two scrolls, or the scroll and the plaster fragment. You want to head to the general store, speak to Arl, chat options 3. Head up the ladder and use your plank on the broken part. Head down the ladder, use your plank on the damaged wall, not the pile of bricks, or else your guy will run around. Talk to Oral again, chat options 4. Teleport to a bank. I'm gonna do Castle Wars, that's the closest one. So I need think he said mackerel. Yep, so I need mackerel. So I'm gonna grab 10 mackerel, use that on the crate. Then 4 tinder boxes. And I guess 3 tinder boxes, and then 10 bronze axes. That should be filled. You can bank your rubble stuff, and for the next part you will need nails, at least 20 nails, 5 planks, spot paste, hammer, crate, stamina, spade, mortantelli, tinder box, coal, 2 steel bars, silver sickle, and gear for a fight. Let's teleport back to Morton. Go back to the general store. Speak to Arl. I want to go back to Razvan. Show options 4. Oh, my bad. You don't actually have to speak to Razvan, but I guess you can. Doesn't hurt. Search the bank. Use your planks on the bank. Go back behind the bank. Use them on the damaged wall. Talk to Cornelius. Show options 4-3. Now you can use that bank, you don't have to teleport to Castle Wars or whatever anymore. Now head to the furnace, or actually head to Razvan now. Now you do have to speak to him. Options 4. Now head to the furnace. Use your steel bars on the furnace, broken furnace. Then your coal. Then your tinder box. There should be a short animation or cutscene. Head to the general store. Talk to Gatherinx. Talk to Whisket. Talk to Vampire Juvenate. And the fight should start. And so you have to use a silver sickle to kill the vampires. Kill all of the vampires and Gatherinx. Use any weapon for Gatherinx. Vampires, you need the silver sickle. Once they're all All Dead, Toxic Gatherings. Then talk to the leaf. Next, head to the bank. For this next part, you will want to bring along 15 salmon. Your silver sickle, steel meds, steel chains, steel legs, another silver sickle. Let's see if I have enough inventory space. So there's 15 salmon. I guess I'll just pot up here in the bank, save space. And then stamina potion, Fort Intelli, and then some food for myself. I'll bring some extra salmon for myself, and 10 GP. So now you want to head north, or use your Mortentelli, then head east to the boat ride. The boat dude over here by Barrows. Do quick travel on the boat, pay 10. North. Cross the bridge. Go through the door over here. Head up to the hideout over here. Talk to the leaf. Talk to Paul Maffey. And then use your steel med on this guy, your steel chain, steel legs, and your just regular silver sickle. And then use your 15 salmon. Talk to him and head out. If you're high level, I'd go on the hard route, or if you're low level, then go on the shorter one. So this part can be hard. On my lower level, it took me multiple tries on the short route. So just, I don't know, I'm not sure about the tactics for this. You might just need some good RNG. That's how I eventually made it on my low level. Just had to keep trying it over and over until I made it. You can probably lure him somewhere where only like one or two can attack him. I'm not sure where. Try to get him into a corner or something. But once you kill all the vampires, that should be done. And if you fail, you're going to end up in the Mortmire Swamp, and you'll have to go back to the bank, get 15 more salmon, go back, give it to him, and repeat the process until you beat it. And if you need a more in-depth guide on how to beat that part, I'd look on YouTube. But personally, I just kept trying over and over until I got some good RNG and beat it. Chat options for Drezzle is 1, 4, 3. Thank you. use the key on the keyhole, go down the trapdoor, search the bookcase, head back up, make sure you at least open the book, then you want to head towards Canifis. Banking Canifis. The items are required are a hammer, sapphire, water, and cosmic rune. Don't attack Edward, so it's going to slow me down. Hammer, sapphire, cosmic, water, rope, soft clay, silver bar, and meath bar. Dominoes in the dueling ring. And I'm set. Now you want to head back to the trapdoor back here. Use your hammer on this boarded up cave. And then enter it. Want to head to the eastern part of the cave, use your soft clay on this coffin, the tomb, teleport to Alcarid. Head to the furnace and use your silver bar on the furnace and make a rod. A slithural rod, whatever it's called. Once you have that, teleport to... I'm gonna go bank and grab a Varrock Telly. You can teleport to Canifis, you can use your Ecto, or you can grab a Varrock Telly like I'm gonna do and teleport to Varrock, or Lumberyard Telly would actually probably be the best. Or Slayer Ring Telly would be really good, or... You want to go back to Drezel, so get back to him however you want. Use your enchant on your rod, sapphire enchant. So once you're here at the Drezel area, you want to go to this well and use your rod on it. Make sure you've used your level 1 enchant on it. That should give you the Rod of Ivendis. Use your Mortentelli. Head back to this town. Go inside. Head to where you cleared the rubble. And the leaf should be down there. Use your rod on him, and that is quest complete.